Ladies and gentlemen, breaking news, we have a fire emergency in the city. But calm down, because cutting-edge bioinformatics is here to put it out. As you can see, we have a heat map displaying the intensity of the fire in various areas of the city. The colors represent the severity of the situation, with red indicating the highest danger zones. This isn't your ordinary fire brigade intervention, it is the power of bioinformatics at work. This groundbreaking visualization technique known as a heat map has a fascinating history. Heat maps not only used in biology, but for example, one of the first known usage of heat maps is credited to the French statistician Toussaint Louis in 1873, which is 4 years earlier before building of Eiffel Tower. It was presenting various social statistics in Paris using colors. Louis' heat map used dark gray and black to denote high value metrics, and like colors like white and light gray to denote lower value metrics. Scientists and data analysts have harnessed the incredible potential of genetic data and computational analysis to combat this crisis. It's truly remarkable to witness how bioinformatics, with its analytical power and scientific expertise, is playing a pivotal role in combating not only fire, but also any analytical or machine learning problems. So stay tuned as we bring you more updates on the remarkable advances happening in the world of science and technology. Greetings everyone, and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to explore gene expression patterns. Firstly, we import our libraries. Then we read the gene expression data from our CSV file. Now let's explore our data. As we can see, the first column in our data is gene symbols, followed by normal sample rep 1, normal sample rep 2, and cancer sample rep 1 and cancer sample rep 2. Now, let's calculate the mean expression for each gene across samples. And then we sort the genes based on the mean expression in descending order. Now let's plot the top genes with the highest mean expression. Top N equal 10. As we can see, we have a bar chart representing the top expressed in genes, which are AC0 13467.1, QRT8P31, and others. Now let's make the gene expression correlation matrix. But before we make it, we have to import our libraries. Next, because in our data we have missing values, we need to perform the mean imputation to handle these missing values. Now let's calculate the correlation between gene expression values. After that, we plot the correlation matrix as a heat map. The gene expression correlation matrix measures the correlation between the expression levels of different genes across all samples. It provides information about the overall patterns of co-expression among genes within and between the control and cancer groups. It's possible to have significant differences in the mean expression values of individual genes between the two groups, as it is indicated by different colors in the correlation matrix, while not observing a significant overall difference in mean expression levels across all genes. As here we can see, the redder the color, the higher the similarity, and the blue is the color, or the darkest blue of the color, the higher the dissimilarity. As here, for example, cancer RIP2, normal RIP1, cancer RIP2, a normal RIP2. Now let's make hierarchical clustering on gene expression data. And here we have it, the GeneExpression hierarchical clustering. In the hierarchical clustering dendrogram, the distance on the y-axis here represents the dissimilarity or distance between samples based on their GeneExpression profiles. A shorter distance indicates that the GeneExpression profiles of two samples are more similar, which is here, this distance. While a longer distance suggests that the GeneExpression profiles are more dissimilar. In our case of the normal and cancer samples, the distance values of 60,000 for normal samples and 70,000 for cancer samples suggest that the GeneExpression profiles of these samples are slightly more similar compared to the cancer samples. The lines in the dendrogram represent the merging of clusters. When two samples or clusters are merged, a line is drawn connecting them at a specific distance. The height at which the line is drawn represents the dissimilarity or distance at which the clusters were merged. By looking at the lines, you can observe the merging and understand how samples or clusters are grouped together based on their similarity. The clustering analysis can reveal groups or subgroups within the samples and provide insights into the underlying structure or similarities in gene expression profiles. Now let's perform the principal component analysis PCA. This code creates a list of numbers I for each column in the expression data frame. Starting from the second column, it checks if each column name starts with the word normal. Because in our case, we are looking for the normal RIP1 and normal RIP2 columns. If it does, the corresponding index I is included in the list. So the code finds the indices of columns that have names starting with normal. Then we plot the PCA result with different colors for normal and cancer samples. And here we have it, the principal component analysis for normal samples versus cancer samples. On the x-axis, we have PCA1, and on the y-axis, we have PCA2. The principal component analysis plot focuses specifically on the normal and cancer groups. It distinguishes between these two groups by assigning different colors to the points representing the normal and cancer samples. The blue points represent the normal samples, while the red points represent the cancer samples. This plot helps visualize the separation or clustering of samples from different groups in the principal component space, providing insights into potential differences between these two conditions. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, then please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share the video, and leave your comment under the comment section. Until next time, happy analyzing.